My name is Isabel Molina, and I'm a board member of ILG. We are a family-owned, vertically integrated rum producer and brand owner. We own and manage various rum brands, but the start of our portfolio is Zacapa Rum. Zacapa was created in 1976 to commemorate the 100-year anniversary of a town in my country called Zacapa. It was in 1997 when we began commercializing internationally. And in 2008, we entered a joint venture with Diageo, the world-leading supplier adult beverage with iconic name brands such as Johnny Walker, Smirnoff, Guinness, just to name but a few. Since the beginning of the partnership, Diageo and ILG have worked together to further accelerate the growth of an outstanding brand to where Zacapa is today, sold in more than 60 countries around the globe. Zacapa Rum is recognized by experts as the best rum in the world. We attribute this acknowledgement to the passion and attention to details our production team exhibits on a daily basis. The making of Zacapa is almost an art that highly differentiates us from other rums. We use virgin sugar cane instead of molasses. We age at the highlands, just above the clouds, instead of at sea levels. We use a Sistema Solera that allows us to use 4 to 5 different barrel types that impart a unique flavor. And last but not least, a conscious woman touch. Our master blender, Lorena Vasquez, is one of the few females in this field. Because our rum has been described by experts as rum like no other and has been awarded nearly every quality award there is to win. Additionally, last year, Zacapa was included in the top 100 most valuable luxury brands across all consumer categories, not just spirits. Zacapa is inexorably linked to Guatemalan history and culture from its conception and provenance to the communities we operate and give back to. For example, the handmade woven petate band that adorns each and every bottle has been specially crafted by local women from various communities. The weaving of petate is an ancient art that dates back from the 1400 BC and was first created by the Mayans. The petate on the bottle is not only an embodiment of the craftsmanship and provenance that characterize Zacapa rum, but is also an important connection to the Guatemalan heritage and an intrinsic connection to the communities. In 1996, Guatemala ended a civil war that lasted for 30 years. In many areas, most of the women were widows. And to make matters worse, these areas of the country happened to be very dry. And with so little water, there was not much to grow out there. As a consequence, people were dying of hunger and malnutrition. And it was then that ILG extended a hand to these communities and started a program with the widows. The ILG family and Diageo, they are committed to provide skills for lives, training employment versus simply extending a philanthropic support. In Guatemala, poverty in these communities is systemic, and our intention is to break this cycle. Today, petate weaving for Zacapa gives these women a constant source of income, allowing them ongoing means to support their families and send children to school. Now, there are more than 900 women involved in the weaving process. By adding the petate to the bottle, Zacapa has created an economic cycle and a tool of self-sufficiency, which did not previously exist, while simultaneously incorporate authentic Guatemalan culture to the brand's DNA. The weavers work from home, individually or in groups with friends, allowing them total flexibility and to set their own schedules, either full or part-time. Given the option for other works, the weavers have told us many times they prefer the petate work to any other manual labor. Beyond providing valuable income, our weaving program provides long-term multi-generational benefits by providing enough stability to allow children to get an education into a country where too many kids spend their life begging at streets. Today, we are very proud to say the number of weaving children at school has more than tripled since 2002. At this time, I would like to share with you a brief video that visually brings to life the importance and meaning of this relationship.
Tiempo empezó por el encargado de la cooperativa, que era un hombre, pero él, siendo un hombre, pensó por las mujeres y buscó a seis señoras, los llevó, trató la manera de conseguir un trabajo, porque en ese tiempo era muy difícil. También he vivido en una familia muy humilde, muy pobre. Queríamos seguir estudiando, no podíamos. Nosotros veíamos a personas que tenían un negocio, tenían todo, y decimos, bueno, ¿por qué ellos tienen? ¿Por qué nosotros no tenemos?
Pues mi marido podía hacer canasta, ese fue el que lo hizo. Y ahí después nosotros hicimos entonces la botella por los materiales timbres. Si fuera que no, no había nada. Ya estamos a ver cómo lloramos de las tristezas. Hice como 150 de botella. Y no me salió bien, salió mal. Me puse a elegir y después me puse a pensar. Lo estuve afinando mi trabajo. Y entonces ahora estoy mejorando con el dinero. Estoy sacando a mis hijos al estudio.
Desde ahora en adelante estoy pensando en qué forma consigo o tener algún negocio. Eso es lo que estoy pensando ahora. Ya tengo una máquina de coser, entonces quiero tener una mini sastrería.
Yo antes no podía expresarme ante un público, no podía decir nada, no quería hablar, me chiviaba. Pero hoy en día no.
Tengo mi negocito también de que me venta de plásticos y también tazas de melamina.
De lo que lo vivimos antes en un tiempo más tristes, y ahorita pues ya nosotros ya nos sentimos felices con los trabajos, tenemos nuestros hijos, tenemos con qué vestir, con qué alimentar.
Es que antes nosotros no tenemos ni un estudio, entonces en la área rural no tenemos ni un ingreso. Solo gracias a Dios a ese trabajo que ahorita estamos trabajando, las mujeres estamos trabajando.
Con la masa en la cabeza, voy al molino, pues con mi trabajo en la mano. La gente pasa y se me quedan viendo y me dicen, ¡ay, qué bonito trabajo hace! Muchísimas gracias, les digo yo, porque sí, me siento muy orgulloso de tener este trabajo.
In addition to the weaving program, Zacapa actively support and participate in other social causes initiatives that are aligned with the brand values and Guatemalan heritage. Another example of Zacapa support to Guatemalan people is throughout microfinancing. For those of you that are not quite familiar with the term, microfinancing is an approach to poverty eradication based on small loans to aspiring third world entrepreneurs, which has proven to be successful in creating sustainable business instead of dependency. Because we know more about ROM than microfinancing, we have worked with the 7BAR Foundation in this field, and we have already funded our first loan recipient fund. This has the potential to impact 200 women and their families annually. The first loan recipients are a cooperative woman in a small town who make and market traditional garments called huipiles. In keeping with the brand's heritage and provenance, the microfinance focus remains on supporting female artisans in Guatemala. While we are satisfied with the work we have been able to do so far, making a sustainable, substantive, and positive impact on communities in Guatemala throughout female empowerment, we realize there is much more yet to be done. But rest assured, whatever the future holds for Zacapa, one thing will always remain constant: the focus and on commitment toward empowering the communities. This determination is one of the reasons we believe that Zacapa brand has grown so strongly over the past years. Apart from being one of the greatest tasting spirits in the market, our authentic link to Guatemala provenance and mystical Mayan roots, combined with our distinct link to the communities and commitment to female empower, allow for consumers around the world to continually discover the magic of Zacapa in every sip. It is my sincere hope that you two have the opportunity to experience the alchemy that Zacapa is in the very near future. Thank you.